Are you filming?
Okay. We're ready when you are. Ready? Mm-hmm. Should I count you down? Mm-hmm.
Hey guys! Thanks so much for watching my first Q&A. Now this is the second to be continued Q&A, talking about all the nitty-gritty details of the Mrs. Potato Head music video. What was it like when you found out you were in Mrs. Potato Head? Well, I was so excited. I was so excited to work with Melanie. But when I first submitted for the role, it didn't even say what artist it was for. It just said the role of wife. And then later when the producers called me to tell me that I booked the role, then they started explaining that it was for Melanie Martinez, and I got really excited. And the concept of the video talking about how there was gonna be cotton candy like pulled out of me, or they said they were gonna make my face look plastic. And so I had no idea, what to expect, but it was awesome. Were you a fan of Melanie before Mrs. Potato Head? So I hadn't heard the song Milk and Cookies. I remember I was listening to Pandora once and the Milk and Cookies song came on, and I was like, oh my God, that is so awesome, because I bake cookies. And I was like, holy shit, that's so cool. Like, who is this? And then I found out it was Melanie. I was like, oh dang, like, she's awesome. Definitely a way bigger fan now. I remember when I first listened to the Mrs. Potato Head song. Oh God, it's still like, it literally gives me chills even when I hear it now, just because it's so beautiful and the message is so powerful. I just love that song so much. How much time did it take to film your part of the video? I was filming for 3 days. What was your reaction meeting Melanie? I remember getting a set and I was like waiting, drinking coffee, and then Melanie and William walked in. I was like, hey, and they seem really nice, and Will was like feeling my hair, like to see the texture of it, and then they basically both asked me how I would feel about getting my bangs cut, because they wanted like the look of straight across bangs, and I didn't have any bangs at all. And so I just remember that was my first interaction with Melanie, and I thought she was really sweet. Did you actually have to get plastic surgery in the Mrs. Potato Head music video? No, I did not, thankfully. What was the plastic surgery like in the video? And also, another question that ties on with this is, what was the most awkward moment? The special effects makeup was pretty crazy. The first day, I think I was in hair and makeup for like 8 hours. And so basically, like, they put fake skin on my face. And so in the scene where I'm laying down, I have to lay super still because, you know, I'm under anesthesia, and the bunny doctor is cutting my face. And, but like, I was really freaked out because the bunny doctor had a mask on, so, you know, the actor under it, like, couldn't really see, and he has these, like, really sharp scissors in his hand, and he's cutting the fake skin, obviously, but, like, right along, like, along my face. And so I just, it was so scary, like, the whole time. I, like, had to be super still, but I kept thinking, like, please don't cut me, like, please don't cut my face, like, I need my face. It was really scary, but funny. A lot of you were asking why the gift box in the beginning of the video is big with the necklace, and in the flashbacks, why is it small? So basically, when we were filming it, we shot the scene, and me and Mr. Potato Head entered the room, and then he starts gifting me the presents. So there were multiple presents. There was like, I think maybe there was even three. There was like a big box with the necklace, and there was a little one, and then maybe there was a third one. And then the note, the plastic surgery appointment note. So when we were filming it, you know, he was just giving me the presents and I was so happy to get them. So I guess in the way that they cut it together at the end, they, you know, they couldn't use all of the footage. So it just looks like separate things, but I don't know, maybe there is a meaning behind it. I'm not really sure. I love what you guys are like analyzing about it, but I don't really know. What was your favorite part during the special effects makeup for the Mrs. Potato Head look? I can't even describe. This was like I said, the first time I ever had to have prosthetics put on my face, and it seems like no big deal. It's like, oh yeah, prosthetics, like whatever, like it's easy, like, and just like whatever, put some glue on or something. But a very long process of how they would put it on. Like, I just remember the lips were so big, and the special effects makeup artists are so talented, and they have very specific ways of doing things. So it takes a long time. But my favorite part of it was probably, I don't know if it was my favorite, but it was just weird. Like, all of a sudden the crew would like walk in to like tell us we had 5 minutes to get to set, and they would just kind of like have like an immediate reaction to seeing me. Like, it was just like I was progressively looking like more and more scary, and so it was really like kind of funny to see the crew's reaction. Were there any scenes that you really enjoyed filming? Ending was really cool to shoot, where I had the blonde wig on and all the prosthetics. Really powerful for me, because as an actor, usually, you know, your character has to go through a change. Like, from the beginning to the end of a scene or of a play, they have to change. And usually it's internal. In the end of Mrs. Potato Head music video, it was both internal and, I mean, obviously she had, like, transformed externally. So to me, it was just so awesome. Like, I feel so grateful and happy to have been a part of was such a powerful role. Favorite part of the Mrs. Potato Head music video? I think my favorite part is, just because it makes me happy when I watch it, is I love seeing Mrs. Potato Head when she's young. Not young, sorry. When she's, you know, innocent at the beginning, when she's first getting flowers from Mr. Potato Head. It just makes me happy. I feel like it's so innocent and just joyful. It was also my favorite outfit to wear. The pink dress was so fun. And the hat, little hat, which, actually, I realized that Mrs. Potato Head, the actual doll Mrs. Potato Head, wears a little hat with a flower on it, just like my character. So, I don't know, they did a really good job at Melanie did a really great job at choosing all the outfits. Like, I was so impressed. The dress was really fun to wear, and it was also really fun to shoot because I didn't have anything on my face. Like, I felt free. All right, so most of you asked what it was like working with Melanie and if it was a fun experience. It was so fun, and it was an awesome experience working with Melanie. Everyone on set was really nice, and we all just like hung out and listened to music and talked a lot. It was just so like relaxed and just like, you know, a dream set to be on. And in terms of Melanie specifically, she's awesome. She's really sweet. She directed the whole thing. It was just so special of an experience to get direction from her. She's really down to earth and really mellow, and she's just like great, really warm energy around her. Okay, someone asked, do you get recognized for the Mrs. Potato Head music video? No, I have not yet been recognized. Yeah. What did you like most about being in the Mrs. Potato Head music video? In the bigger picture, I love the message. That's just so powerful. In terms of the actual like set, when I was younger, this is sounds weird, but my favorite color was literally like sparkly pink. So when I got to set and literally everything was pink and sparkly, like the wheelchair was like covered in pink sparkles, and then the IV drip syringe was pink sparkles. Oh gosh, just everything, the aesthetics, it was like a dream world for me. What is your favorite song of Melanie's? I love Training Wheels, and I love Milk and Cookies. I don't know, I mean, it's really hard to choose. Like, all of her songs are really good in their own way. They all definitely get Sebastian. Should we let Sebastian? So, hold on, I'm getting my dog. Come here, Sebastian. Come here. Oh, yeah. So I love the song Soap. I love Carousel, honestly. So, wait, are you going to appear in any future Melanie music videos? You know, I would love to. It was really a great experience, and I hope I work with her again. How do you feel about the Mrs. Potato Head music video now? Do you like how it turned out? Yes, I most definitely love how it turned out. You know, the reaction from you guys has seriously been so heartwarming. We shot it a few months ago. Like, we shot it in September. I remember when I finally saw it, I was so happy. I was just like, holy shit. Funnest memory on the Potato Head shoot. Everyone kept asking if it was my real hair that he was cutting. It wasn't, it was a wig. I was supposed to be laying there sleeping, and then Justin, Mr. Potato Head, came in and was like, had to cut my wig. And it was just, it was fun. How has essentially becoming almost a face for Mrs. Potato Head changed your life? The video and the reaction has been so powerful, and I love interacting with you guys, and it just makes me really happy. It makes me smile. You know, I'm still an up-and-coming actress, so the response has been great. Also, I feel really strongly about Melanie's message of the video, you know. I just really want to relay that message. you know, everyone around the world that it's really important to love yourself. I hope that this video reaches people and makes a difference. I really just want to pass that message along. All right, well, that's it. That's the Q&A. I'm working on some other stuff for the YouTube channel. Also, feel free to let me know if you guys have any ideas for topics or videos. I'm always open to ideas, so just let me know in the comments. Yay, we did it! See you soon.